Welcome to JASreacts. I'm Josh.
Hey, I'm Bekah.
And we're going to watch a movie trailer. This one is Star Wars Episode 9. And we literally just started talking about what we know about this trailer. Because let's be honest, Star Wars, it's almost impossible to avoid
it is.
Star Wars stuff.
It is impossible.
So for me, I had the title spoiled for me almost instantly. Even though I saw that the trailer was released and I avoided the trailer, I got like the episode name, even though I scrolled past it as fast as I could online. It got spoiled for me. It got spoiled for me again when I had to get the video for the reaction. So I know that. And I sort of have, I think, one of the villains spoiled for me because I've seen some like thumbnail stuff online. Mm-hmm. And I didn't know if it was a joke, but I'm assuming I've seen it enough times now that it's probably real. And you were just saying that you had preserved it for the show and haven't seen any of this, right?
That's right.
No. So what is your circumstances
of
what you've seen?
My husband was super, super excited. And he's like, I wanted to show you this. And I said, I'm not supposed to watch it. He's like, what? Come on. I want to show you this trailer. I've been waiting for it.
And listen, if Zach wants to be on the show, all he has to do is ask. Okay.
So anyway, I got peer pressured.
So and you have seen it.
I watched it, yes.
Well, this is fresh for me.
I ruined it again.
So what's your relationship with Star Wars? Big fan, not a fan, seen them
all?
I'm a
fan.
Seen any?
I've seen all of them. I've been a fan since I was a kid. Used to, you know, stay up, well, as late as our parents would let us, me and my brothers, and watch, you know, the old school trilogy. I'm not a diehard fan where I know every single little side character's name. I'm not like that. But I am a fan of the series, and I think they're fun. They're fun to watch.
What did you think of The Last Jedi?
I liked it. I'm liking the newer ones. I know there's a lot of mixed reviews out there. There are people that either really enjoy them, or there's people that just hate them. And I feel like with Star Wars, there's nothing you can do. I think there's always going to be people out there that hate what's going on. Yeah. And for them, you know, nothing is going to compare to the original, you know, the original trilogy, which is understandable. But yeah.
For me, I mean, no movie is perfect. Every movie has highs and lows, I think. I think Star Wars is no different. I'm familiar with the franchise. I own the whole series, the mainline, original trilogy, prequel trilogy, the new movies. I own them because I respect and appreciate their place in film history, which is my number one passion and what I want to do with my life. So I have, you know, nothing but respect for the franchise and, you know, what it, I could only dream to have like 100,000th of a percentage of somebody be interested in something that I made, let alone such a rabid fan base for such a big movie.
Oh yeah.
You know, and like with all franchises, they get more powerful than you can possibly imagine. You know what I mean? Like, you can't anticipate the following that is going to occur.
No.
So, you know, Star Wars is, you know, I think Kathleen Kennedy has basically said Star Wars is its own genre. Mm-hmm. And I agree with that. It's not.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's not sci-fi because it's not science-based. And it's not necessarily fantasy because, I don't know, I mean, I guess closest would be fantasy. But it's also realistic where it's like they're just humans. They're just people, but they have these different... Anyway, I totally agree with the assessment that it's its own genre. I respect it. The Last Jedi... Just to, I don't know, in case anybody watches this who has an opinion about The Last Jedi, are those people out there? I'm not sure. I'm
sure they are.
I would say that from a character perspective, I love it because it was written and directed by Rian Johnson, who made Looper, which you've never seen, which I've already shamed you for. So I was actually, that was the first Star Wars movie I was ever literally excited about because it was that guy making it. And then when I saw it, I was like, oh, so there's not a lot of plot here. Because really, I mean, Last Jedi is character. It's a character-based movie. It's here's what challenges. You know, what does this character think that you know they know, and how do I challenge that? Both for Rey and her parents, for Poe, the hot-headed pilot who gets taken down a peg. You know, say what you want about how he gets taken down a peg and the realisticness of it. It was basic. It was a character piece. There's not a ton of plot. I mean, what's the plot of The Last Jedi? Some ships are running away in space and we're running out of gas. That's the plot of The Last Jedi, right? Mm-hmm. And then there's some Snoke stuff. But it didn't bother me because I loved the character work.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, I'm very curious to see if this movie has a more interesting plot. Because I'm a plot junkie.
Mm-hmm.
I love, like, what happens to these people. What surprises are in store. Mm-hmm. Not necessarily like, oh, I like vanilla ice cream. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know. I don't get into that. I get into, that's great, have characters that I'm interested in, but have something interesting happen to them.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't know. Let's just watch this.
We've passed on all we know. A thousand generations live in you now. But this is your fight.
I mean, they said that last time.
Once, but I want to hear, since I've already seen it before, I got to hear what your comments are on it, what your thoughts are.
All right, so
you made a face.
that's probably a bad thing. So I want to talk about, I mean, I have a lot I want to talk about.
Okay,
so we'll go back and forth, but okay. I'll start with the title.
Mm-hmm.
I just knew, like, even when I read it online before I saw it, I knew that it was going to have one of the Star Wars buzzwords in the title because they can't help themselves.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Force, Jedi, Skywalker. Like, of course, you know, at least, like, with the prequels And even the original trilogy, it seemed like, I don't know, there was a little more variety in what was talked about. A Phantom Menace, Attack of Clones, Revenge of Sith, you know, a New Hope, The Empire Strikes Back, Return of the Jedi. I think, I don't know. So then, of course, now with the current, the people making them now who grew up as fans, mm-hmm. it's like they can't help themselves. What if it said Force? What if we put Jedi in it? Let's just call it Skywalker. Let's just not even call it Star Wars anymore. Let's just call it Skywalker.
Well, and
I don't know.
So, I think, doesn't that get into the plot though too with the whole Skywalker thing with Rey?
Why does everything have to rise? The Dark Knight rises.
I don't know. Things rise.
The Planet of the Apes rises. Now Skywalkers have to rise.
Things are rising.
Everything. All the time.
Bread is rising.
I honestly was hoping that J.J. Abrams was going to be like, oh, okay, you don't want me to remake A New Hope. You don't want me to remake it. Then fine. I'm going to go batshit crazy because this is it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But no. I think maybe with The Last Jedi, again, what we're seeing... It's like 100 thoughts right now. What we're seeing is big budget movie making based on commerce and the ramifications of fan expectations versus artistic integrity.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the mixed reactions for The Last Jedi and the vocal minority backlash, you can't ignore it.
Mm-hmm.
So now maybe they're forced. To kind of draw in the reins and not get so weird and just say, okay, here's that character you like and here's that villain you remember and here's that, you know, and you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I got what you're saying. For me, I don't really care what the name is.
Okay.
I don't care that much. You had a very good, long thought out process about that.
The title.
It was very, very good.
I don't care.
And I'm like, I don't care.
So here's the last thing I do want to say really quickly is a prediction is I think the rise of Skywalker is Kylo Ren.
Yeah.
I think it's his rise. I don't think they're
going to.
Don't think they're going to retcon that she's a nobody. I really don't because I think that just like Rian Johnson, J.J. Abrams. Like, they're trying to respect each other's voices. I will say that. Mm-hmm. Like, J.J. Abrams, when Force Awakens came out, he said, because everybody was like, oh, you're going to take midichlorians out? Or are you going to pretend the prequels don't exist? Blah, 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 blah. He said, no, let it be known. I'm not undoing a single thing George Lucas did. Mm-hmm. Good or bad, that is Star Wars,
that's
all of it.
You Star know what Wars. I mean? Yep.
That's Star Wars.
Mm-hmm.
And so he said, I'm not undoing a single thing that George Lucas did. And then Rian Johnson stepped in, and he took the baton, and he continued it. And then he has also said, I do not care what J.J. Abrams does with Episode 9. It is his movie. I can't wait to enjoy it as a fan.
Mm-hmm.
So I think J.J. Abrams, as a sign of respect as well, if he's not going to undo 30 years of George Lucas, he's not going to undo 2 years of Rian Johnson.
No.
That's my opinion.
Yeah, I don't foresee it either.
I think the rise of Skywalker is Kylo Ren. Mm-hmm. I think the message is going to be, you can murder your parents and become a good person.
All right.
Well, because I mean, I guess parent right now, but I'm going to assume, I mean, we have to assume Princess Leia we're going to get her send off in this movie. Mm. That's my guess. Anyway, you excited to see it?
I am excited to see it. I am.
Wasn't as much there as I was hoping. It was a 2-minute trailer and it was 60 seconds of desert. You know
yeah,
I mean?
It was. It was still kind of exciting. The just overall bigness of, or is that a word? It is now. The whole picture of it, you know, the big landscapes, the big music,
the John Williams score.
Yes, it just gets your blood pumping.
I like the color scheme too. It's like a blue purple something in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I think that I will probably have maybe more thoughts when the next trailer comes out and we get a little bit more plot going.
Because you know they're going to come out with many more.
Yep, I mean at least two. So.
I mean, it's April. Comes out in December. So
yeah, plenty of time.
Yeah, they'll come out with more.
So I don't know. I mean, I'm not a huge Star Wars guy, but I'm weirdly, like, I want to know what's going to happen. Just as much for the internals of the story, mm-hmm. as much as the political filmmaking mm-hmm. side of the handling the fan base mm-hmm. and Rian Johnson and J.J. Abrams and the legacy. Like, I'm fascinated by all of mm-hmm. that stuff just as much as I am about that's finding out.
It's a huge undertaking, yeah.
My point, the thing is, you can't win.
No, you can't.
So what they
so just make the best movie that you like, you know, and then
ignore the praise and ignore the negativity and say, I'm J.J. Abrams, this is my legacy, this mm-hmm. is the movie I want to make, mm-hmm. the end, mm-hmm. and be done with it.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Easier said than done in a house in Iowa than making the movie.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, yeah, that's going to do it for this episode. If you like what you see, follow us on the socials in the bottom of your screen. Like and share and subscribe wherever you follow. Once again, I'm Josh.
I'm Becca.
And this has been JASreacts.